Hey, this is Puneet back again, and in this video, we'll see 10 keyboard shortcuts that probably you're not using, and these shortcuts will definitely going to increase your efficiency in work while using Excel. So let's get started. There is a shortcut key in Excel that you can use to open the inbuilt user form that Excel has. Now let's say you want to enter data in these columns. First, you need to convert this into a table. So for this, use the shortcut key Control T. And tick mark my table has headers and click OK. Now from here, the shortcut key you need to press is Alt D O and it will open the user form that you can use to enter data. The second shortcut key is for creating a chart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the data and press the shortcut key Alt plus F1. And it will instantly insert a column chart. Now the column chart is my default chart right now, but if you want to insert a line chart instead of column chart, so what you need to do is you need to go to the insert tab and open the all charts option here and go to the line chart, right click and set as default chart. So if I come back now, cancel and press the shortcut key Alt plus F1 again. So it will insert the line chart. Now we all know that shortcut key to add a sum is Alt plus equals, but we can use the same shortcut key to add multiple totals. So here I have small data for months and years, and I want to add total for every column and every row. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this data from here and one row down and one column right. And again, I'm going to press Alt plus equals and it will add total for all the columns and rows. And if you work with textual data in a worksheet, you can use the shortcut key F7 to perform a spell check. So it will go through the entire worksheet and show you all the spelling errors that you have in the worksheet. You can correct them one by one and you can also correct them using change all. Now what happens when we need to select multiple cells that are non-continuous, we need to press the control key. And then we need to select each cell one by one. So like if I press control and then I select this, this and here. But there is a shortcut key that you can use, Shift plus F8. And the moment you press this shortcut key, it will activate add or remove section where you don't need to press control key, but you can select multiple cells simply using your cursor. So if I need to select, and right now I'm not using control key here. And if you want to deselect any cell or range, you simply need to go back and click on it. So whenever I insert a new sheet, I instantly rename it. And the shortcut key which I use is Alt H O R. When I press this shortcut key, it allows me to rename the worksheet. And in the same way, if I want to delete a worksheet, the shortcut key I use is Alt H D S. In Excel, there is an option called auto format, which helps you to apply quick formatting to the data that you have in the worksheet. So to open this option, you need to use the shortcut key Alt O A, and it will give you it will show you this dialog box where you can choose the formatting that you want to apply. And you also have options that you can choose from. And now let's say you can use the shortcut key Control and colon to insert the current date in a cell, and that date is a hard value. It's not a formula that will change automatically when you update the worksheet. And along with that, if you want to insert the current time, the shortcut key is Control Shift and then again colon. So basically, if you want to add current date and current time in a cell, you need to press two shortcut keys. The first is Control plus colon, and then you need to add a space and then Control Shift and colon. I'm sure you have heard about flash fill, and there is also a shortcut key that you can use to apply flash fill. So let's suppose if I want to get the first name from this list of names, the shortcut key what I'm going to use is Control plus E. Last but not least, if you want to apply a full screen to Excel, you can use the shortcut key Alt V U. So it will instantly give you a full screen view of your Excel application. And if you want to come back, you simply need to press Escape. I hope you found this video useful. And if you have a favorite shortcut key that you want to share with me, please go to the comment section